Let us take some problems on belt drives. I'll mark the question. Let's read what is given here. An open belt drive running over two pulleys, 240 mm and 600 mm diameter, connects two parallel shafts 3 meter apart. Full stop. The power to be transmitted is 4 kilowatts from the smaller pulley that rotates at 300 rpm. Coefficient of friction between belt and pulley is 0.3 and the safe working tension is 10 Newton per mm width. Determine number 1 minimum width of belt, second initial belt tension and third length of belt required. So this is the question which we have. Whatever is given here, I will write that in the form of data first. So let us start this problem by writing the data. Here first I'll write the type of belt drive. It is given that here we have open belt drive. So I'll write here, it is an open belt drive. Next, an open belt running over two pulleys, 240 mm and 600 mm diameter, connects two parallel shafts which are 3 meter apart. Now, one of the diameter is 240 and the other is 600 mm. I'll draw the diagram for this. It is given that here we have an open belt drive. Now, this is an open belt drive. The two pulleys, they are having diameter 240 and 600 mm. So, for the bigger pulley, I will say that here the diameter is D1 and for smaller pulley, the diameter is D2. So, D1 is equal to 600 mm given, that is 0.6 meter, and D2 is equal to 240 mm, that is 0.24 meter. Next, connects two parallel shafts 3 meter apart. It means this belt drive, it is connecting two parallel shafts which are 3 meters apart. That is, the distance between center to center distance between the two shafts is given. So that distance I'll denote it by letter X. X is equal to 3 meter. Next, the power to be transmitted is 4 kilowatts. Power is given. P is equal to 4 kilowatts. So that is 4 into 10 raised to 3 watts. Next, the power to be transmitted is 4 kilowatts from the smaller pulley. It means smaller pulley is the driver here. So here I can say that this smaller pulley is the driver. Means smaller pulley would be rotating and through the belt power would be transmitted to the driven pulley. And from the smaller pulley that rotates at 300 rpm, speed of the smaller pulley is given. So since smaller pulley I am denoting it by 2, so I'll write down speed as n2 is equal to 300 rpm. Next, coefficient of friction between belt and pulley is 0.3, so that is the value of mu. And safe working tension is 10 Newton per mm width. So safe tension is equal to 10 Newton per mm width. Determine, question number 1 is minimum width of belt. Here we have to calculate how much will be the width of belt? I am denoting it by letter B. Next, we have to find out initial belt tension, that is T suffix 0, and length of belt required, that is we have to calculate how much is the length of belt which is necessary for this open belt drive. Now this is the question which we have in front of us. Let us try to get the solution for this question. Now, since they have given that D2 here, the smaller pulley is the driver, what I will do, RPM is given. From RPM, I will first calculate the velocity of belt which is passing through this smaller pulley. So, solution, I'll say that since velocity of belt passing over smaller pulley is given by velocity for smaller pulley, that would be V2 is equal to pi D2 into upon 60, that is the formula is pi dn by 60. So from this I will be getting the value of V2. Therefore V2 is equal to pi into D2 value, it is given as 0.24 meters into RPM is given, that is 300 divided by 60. So from this if I calculate, I will get the velocity of belt which is passing over the smaller pulley, and my answer is 3.77 meter per second. This is the peripheral velocity of, you can say, pulley 2, or in other words, it is the velocity of belt which is passing over the smaller pulley. Now, after this, after calculating the velocity, next, we know that since power transmitted by belt drive is given by, it is given by P is equal to T1 minus T2 multiplied by velocity. Since here I know the velocity of belt which is V2, I'll write here V2, and this will be my equation number 1. Next, here I know the value of power and velocity V2, I will put the values. So therefore power is 4000 watts is equal to T1 minus T2 into velocity V2, we have just calculated it was 3.77 meter per second. So from this we will get the relation of T1 and T2. I'll say that therefore T1 minus T2 is equal to 1061. I will keep this as second equation. Now we want to calculate T1 and T2 here, because the first question is we have to calculate how much is the minimum width of the belt. So for minimum width of belt we require the values of T1 and T2. After this I'll say that since angle of lap for open belt drive is given by theta is the angle of lap, and it is equal to 180 minus 2 into alpha. I will keep this as the third equation. Now here I need to calculate what is alpha. So I'll say that where alpha is equal to, alpha is given by the formula sine inverse, it is d1 minus d2 upon 2x, that is the formula of alpha. Hence, it is equal to sine inverse of d1. It was 240 mm, or you can say d1 was 600 mm, so it is 0.6 meters minus d2 0.24 divided by 2 into x, it was 3. So therefore, from this, if I calculate, alpha comes out to be, it is 3.44 degree. Now, after getting alpha, I will put alpha in equation number 3. Therefore, putting alpha is equal to 3.44 in equation 3. I'll get the value of theta. So, theta will be equal to 180 minus 2 into 3.44. So, therefore, theta is equal to 173.12 degree. Now, we need to convert this theta into radians, because in the calculation part, we require theta to be in radian. So, here I'll multiply theta with pi and divide this by 180. So, theta will come out to be 3.022 radian. Now, once I know theta, I can use the belt tension ratio. I'll say that since belt tension ratio is given by belt tension ratio, it is T1 upon T2 is equal to e raised to mu theta. This formula we have to remember in case of power transmission for a belt drive. Therefore, here I can say that e raised to mu value is given, it is 0.3, and theta we have found out, we have to keep the value. Remember, this theta has to be in terms of radian. So, here it is 3.022. So, finally, I will get the relation of T1 and T2. It is T1 is equal to 2.5 times of T2. So, this is the relation of T1 and T2 which we have. I will give this as equation number capital A. Now, once we know the relation, we can put the value in equation number 2. That is, we will replace T1 with 2.5 times of T2. So, I will say that put T1 is equal to 2.5 T2 in equation 2. Therefore, here I have 2.5 T2 minus T2 is equal to 1061. From this, if we calculate, T2 value comes out to be, it is 718 Newton. Now we will put this T2 value in equation A and get the value of T1. Put T2 is equal to 718 Newton in equation number capital A. Therefore, T1 is equal to 2.5 into 718, and my answer of T1, this comes out to be 1779 Newton. So these are the values of T1 and T2. Now in the question, they have given that the safe belt tension, the safe tension is 10 Newton per mm width. This safe tension is nothing, but it is equal to the maximum tension. So safe tension is equal to maximum tension. And now, maximum tension is nothing but T1, that is tension in tight side. Safe tension is 10 Newton per mm width. It means, I'll explain it to you all here. It is, safe tension is 10 Newton per mm width of belt, per mm width of belt. So it means 1 mm width of belt will be able to resist 10 Newton of load. So here we have to see, if the load is 1779, because out of T1, T2, we have to select the maximum value. If the load is 1779 Newton, then how much will be the width? That is B. So I'll have to cross multiply here. So here I'll get the relation. Now, since width of belt required, that is equal to the width of belt which is required, it will be 1779 divided by 10. So therefore B comes out to be 177.9 mm, or we can say that it is almost equal to 178 mm. So this will be the first answer. The next question is, we have to calculate initial tension in the belt, that is T0. We know that T0 is the average of T1 and T2. So after this, I'll write down, since initial tension in the belt T0 is equal to T1 plus T2 divided by 2. So therefore T0 will be equal to, T1 is 1779, T2 is 718 divided by 2. So if I calculate from here, I will get my answer of T0 as, it comes out to be 1248.5 Newton. It means initially the belt has to be in this much amount of tension so that it is mounted over the pulley. Now the last question, here we have to calculate how much is the length of belt which is required over this open belt drive. So I'll use the formula for open belt drive, that is, since length of open belt drive, it is given by the formula, it is pi into R1 plus R2 plus 2x plus R1 minus R2 whole square divided by x. This is the formula of length of belt required for open belt drive. If it is cross belt drive, then the only change will be, here instead of R1 minus R2, it will be R1 plus R2. So I'll say that therefore L is equal to pi R1, since D1 is 600 mm, means 0.6 meter, so R1 will be half of that, means 0.3, plus R2, D2 was 0.24 meter, so R2 is 0.12, plus 2 into x is 3, plus 0.3 minus 0.12 whole square divided by x is 3. So from this I will get the length of belt in terms of meter. It comes out to be 7.33 meter, or if I convert, it will be 7330 mm, means this much is the length of belt which is required for the open belt drive which is given in this question. So here they were saying us to calculate three different things. First, the width of belt required. Width of belt we have calculated, it was 178 mm. Initial tension we have calculated 1248.5 newton, and length of belt required, that is 7.33 meter. With this, the problem is completed.